Hi, I'm Jennifer, and I'm here today to walk you through your new sewing machine. If you've never sewn before, a sewing machine may seem like a complicated piece of equipment. I'm here to tell you that with a little bit of practice, you can become a sewing master. I'm going to help you start that journey today. First, we're going to walk through the different parts of your sewing machine. Next, I'm going to show you how to set up your sewing machine. And last, I'm going to walk you through how you can make your very first stitches. Let's get started. Knowing the different parts of your sewing machine is going to make learning to sew that much easier. Let's learn the different parts of your sewing machine. Starting on the side here, we have your power switch and the machine socket. We also have our hand wheel. Turning the hand wheel forward makes the needle of your machine go up and down. Moving to the front of the machine, we have a reverse stitch button, and we have our stitch guide printed right on the machine for easy reference. We have two dials. The dial on the right is the stitch length selector, and the dial on the left is the stitch pattern selector. Going to the top of the machine, we have some items that you'll use to wind a bobbin. We have our bobbin winder spindle and our bobbin winder stopper. Over here, we have our bobbin winder thread guide, and this puts tension on the thread as we wind our bobbin. We also have two spool pins, and these are for your spools of thread. We have your carrying handle. Moving along to the side, if you take your hand wheel and turn it forward, you will see the thread uptake lever will appear. Going down the machine, we have our thread tension dial here. Following down the machine, we have our presser foot area. There are a couple of items down here to note. So this in front, this is a presser foot. It is attached to your presser foot holder. There's a lever to the side of your presser foot, and that is your presser foot lever. If that is down, your presser foot is down. If it's up, your presser foot is up, and you can even press it up one stop higher to really get that foot up in the air to get thick things like quilts under your sewing machine. We have our needle here and our needle screw. By loosening the screw, you can change out your needle. Underneath your needle and your presser foot area, you have your throat plate. Your throat plate comes with several markings on it, and those are to help you sew straight lines and to help you manage even seam allowances. Continuing down the machine, we have here our extension table. If you remove your extension table, it reveals an accessories compartment, so you can store thread and different notions in it. Putting that aside, you can see here the free arm. Pulling down the flap in the front of your machine, you'll see this is where your bobbin is housed, and we will talk more about that when we wind and install our bobbin. There are a couple last things to note about your new sewing machine. Your sewing machine comes with three extra presser feet here. We have a buttonhole foot, a blind hem foot, and a zipper foot. We also have a pack of needles, three extra bobbins, a darning plate, and a seam ripper. Those are all the different parts of your new sewing machine. If you forget any of them or have any additional questions, don't forget to refer to your sewing machine manual. It's full of lots of really helpful information.